Hello guys, welcome to Hindu Response and thanks for joining me. In previous video, I have explained how missionaries use half-baked so-called references to prove caste discrimination and violence in Hindu scriptures so that they can convert Hindus. If you haven't watched that video, I request you guys to watch it. It works as a base for this video. The link is in description and in my pinned comment. Also, please press the subscribe button and ring the notification bell if you are new to this channel. That being said, let's go. The blog says, there is ample justification in Bhagavad Gita alone to maintain caste divisions and oppression. I created mankind in four classes, different in their qualities and actions. Though unchanging, I am the agent of this, the actor who never acts. Bhagavad Gita 4:13. Verse 4:13 within the Bhagavad Gita shows that mankind is established in four classes, varnas. This means that castes which have been created are not changeable because they are set when people are created. You are born with a caste and die in the same caste. Vedas says that caste or class is based on birth. It only says that Sri Krishna created the varna, that is class, based on qualities of the person and on actions done by the individuals. In fact, this verse is used to prove that there is no such thing as caste present in Hindu dharma. And this verse is an answer to Arjuna's question, which goes like this. When irreligion is prominent in the family, O Krishna, the women of the family become corrupt. And from the degradation of womanhood, O descendant of Rinshi, comes unwanted progeny. When there is increase of unwanted population, a hellish situation is created, both for the family and for those who destroy the family tradition. In such corrupt families, there is no offering of oblations of food and water to the ancestors. Due to the evil deeds of the destroyers of family tradition, all kinds of community projects and family welfare activities are devastated. O Krishna, maintainer of the people, I have heard by disciplic succession that those who destroy family tradition will always in hell. So, here Arjuna says that if there is no family to take care, then no one will follow their duties and it will lead to social disturbance. And in such situations, woman becomes corrupt and it leads the ancestors to hell, as there will be no one who will perform religious duties of honoring the dead. For this, Krishna answers that varna is based on qualities and actions they do. Even in Bible, there is exactly a parallel situation happened. Look at Ezra 9. After these things had been done, the officials approached me and said, the people of Israel and the priests and the Levites have not separated themselves from the peoples of the lands with their abominations, from the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Jebusites, the Ammonites, the Moabites, the Egyptians, and the Amorites, for they have taken some of their daughters to be wives for themselves and for their sons, so that the holy race amixed itself with the peoples of the lands, and in this faithlessness the hand of the officials and chief men has been foremost. Ezra 10. And Ezra the priest stood up and said to them, you have broken faith and married foreign women, and so increased the guilt of Israel. Now, then make confession to the Lord, the God of your fathers, and do his will. Separate yourselves from the peoples of the land and from the foreign wives. The Bible clearly said that priests, Levites, and other tribes of Israel married foreigners. Because of them, they polluted the land as per Ezra chapter 9. And God ordered them to divorce those women and leave those kids. So, Krishna is saying that even if a woman intermarry with other class, it does not matter, as the varna is based on qualities and actions done by the kid is somehow encouraging caste discrimination according to the missionary. But the missionary has no problem when the Bible says to give divorce and leave those kids. The blog says, for finding refuge in me, even those who though are born of the womb of sin, women, Vaishyas and Sudras too, reach the supreme goal. Bhagavad Gita 9:32. Isn't this an utter obscenity and contempt based on birth? What does he mean absurd and contempt based on birth? Because as per Bible, Romans 5:12, therefore, just as sin came into the world through one man and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sinned. Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. 1 Timothy 2:14. And Adam was not the one deceived, it was the woman who was deceived and became a sinner. According to Paul, whom most missionaries give more importance than Jesus, clearly says that all are sinners because of mistake done by one man, and all sinners should die.
Now the Catholics believe that as long as you accept Jesus before you die, anyone can get into heaven.
Really? Anyone?
I accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Yes!
And what does it mean doing sin? Sin means not obeying the laws given by biblical God. What Hindus believe is pap, which means evil or wicked deeds that harm others without following morality. I already made videos showing the difference between those two. The link is in description. The original word is papayona, means who are born in wicked families. For example, a woman who is born into a family of prostitute, a vaishya who is born in the family of evil businessman, a sudra who is born in the family of wicked workers. And if you look into the previous verses, it says that anyone who worships Krishna truly, even if he's the most evil person, then he will turn into a good guy, and such person should be respected. The blog says, the strictness of caste responsibilities is mentioned clearly in verses 3-4 and 3-5 of Bhagavad Gita. A person can never achieve freedom from reactions to activities without first performing prescribed Vedic duties, neither can perfection be attained by renouncing them as well. Bhagavad Gita 3-4. No one exists for even instant without performing an action. However unwilling, every being is forced to act by the qualities of nature. Bhagavad Gita 3:5. Look at the original verse. There is no mention of Vedic sacrifice at all. The blog says, further, Bhagavad Gita makes sure that people stick to their prescribed duties. It is far better to perform one's Swadharma, prescribed duties, even though faulty, than another's duties perfectly. Restriction in the course of performing one's own duty is better than engaging in others' duties, for to follow another path is dangerous. The wise should not create doubt in the minds of ignorant people who are attached to fruitful actions by inducing them to stop work, rather by performing their duties in an enlightened manner. They should inspire the ignorant also to do their prescribed duties. Bhagavad Gita 3:26. Throughout the history, the so-called lower caste have risen against oppression and have rebelled against the caste system. The threat that so-called lower caste might pose in future is taken care of with such verses. Bhagavad Gita makes sure that one does not rebel or encourage others to rise against the oppression, and instructs to keep on following the prescribed caste duties. This is actually an answer given by Sri Krishna to Arjuna's question, that is, chapter 2 verse 4, Arjuna said, O killer of Madhu, Krishna, how can I counterattack with arrows in battle men like Bhishma and Drona, who are worthy of my worship? It is better to live in this world by begging than to live at the cost of the lives of great souls who are my teachers. Even though they are avaricious, they are nonetheless superiors. If they are killed, our spoils will be tainted with blood. It means here Sri Krishna tells Arjuna that he shouldn't waste his inborn talent by choosing to beg food just cause he can't kill his family members who are evil. We all know that how many times Kauravas tried to kill Pandavas. They even insulted Draupadi woman by trying to disrobe her in front of hundreds of people. They turned Pandavas into slaves by taking their kingdom in unlawful manner. For example, it's like an athlete saying that he will give up his ambition because of some corrupt people in sports organization instead of fighting them. Again, if that's wrong, then how come God in Bible killing Ammonites is justified? That too including newborn kids. Entire blog of is filled with misrepresentation and false propaganda. And finally, the missionary in the blog says, these satanic verses from the Bhagavad Gita cannot be explained away. You either agree or disagree with them. And all those who try to explain these verses in any other way certainly are supporters of the caste system and are enjoying the fruit of caste system. If we go by his logics, then here Jesus clearly supporting slavery. Matthew 6:24. Holman Christian Standard Bible. No one can be a slave of two masters, since either he will hate one and love the other, or be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot be slaves of God and of money. And that's it for today, guys. And we will catch up again with another topic exposing this mystery. Yours, Hindu Response.
आपको अच्छी लगी तो ऐसे थोड़ा मार दीजिए हाथ आप थोड़ा सा मार दीजिए एक बार मार दीजिए क्यों कष्ट हो रहा है आपको अगर अच्छी लगी मार दीजिए